Hello everyone, welcome to the channel. We have a challenging quartic equation to be solved for x. We have x to the power 4 minus 3x minus 2 is equal to 0. Now we will try to factor this into two quadratics, then solve that quadratics. Now my friends, let's write an x square here and an x square in the other term. We will have plus and minus ax terms. This is minus ax term. Since we have no x cubed term here, by this we will cancel x cubed terms. We have negative ax cubed and positive ax cubed. Now this will cancel, and let's say the constant here is b and the constant here is c. We have three unknowns, and we will try to find these unknowns. Now my friends, as I said, we have x to the power of 4. And we cancel x cubes. Let's find x square terms. X square terms, the first one we can say is c times x squared. The second one, from x times x, here we will have negative a squared times x. And again, b times x squared will give us bx squared, and this will be 0 since we have no x squared term. So from this we reach one of our equation, that is c minus a squared plus b is equal to 0. Let's write this. Now x terms will come from ax times c. Ax times c becomes acx, and the second one is b times negative ax, which is negative abx. This is equal to negative 3x. That's right, this is equal to negative 3x. So ac minus ab becomes negative 3. This is the second equation we get, and lastly the constant term b times c is equal to negative 2. We have b times c is equal to negative 2. We have three variables, three unknowns, and three equations, so this should be solvable. Now the first one is b plus c is equal to a squared. If we have a squared this side, the second one we can write this as a times b minus c is equal to 3, cancelling by the negative by minus and grouping we have this, and lastly we have b times c is equal to negative 2. This is the system we have to solve. Now my friends, let me show you what I will do. We have b plus c is equal to a squared, and let's say we have b minus c is equal to 3 over a. Adding these two, we have 2b is equal to a squared plus 3 over a. So B is equal to 1/2 of this a squared plus 3 over a. Similarly, we can find c, subtracting the 2, we will have 2 times c is equal to 2 times c is equal to a squared minus 3 over a. So c becomes a squared minus 3 over a, all divided by 2. This is c. Now we can use these two in our last equation. B times c is equal to negative 2. So it's right here. We have b times c is equal to negative 2. Our b is a squared minus, plus 3 over a, all divided by 2, and c is a squared minus 3 over a, all divided by 2, and this is equal to negative 2. On top, we have difference of two squares. We can write a to the power of 4 minus 9 over a squared divided by 4. And this is equal to negative 2 multiplying by 4a squared. The two sides multiplying by 4a squared, we will have 4. Let's just write this as a to the 6th power minus 9 equals negative 8a squared. This is our equation. Now, if you let a squared be some t, then we have t cubed minus 9 is equal to negative 8t. So this is a cubic. We have t cubed plus 8t minus 9 is equal to 0. From the rational zero theorem, we can say t is equal to 1 is a root. Actually, the only real root of this cubic is t is equal to 1. You can use the synthetic division to see the other quadratic has no real root. So t is equal to 1 and t was equal to a squared. So t is equal to a squared is equal to 1. So a is plus minus 1. It doesn't matter you use plus or minus sign, since in our quadratics we have plus ax and minus ax in our factorization. Let's say, without loss of generality, let a be equal to 1. Then, if a is equal to 1, a is equal to 1, then we have b plus c is equal to a squared, which is 1 squared. This is equal to 1. And we have b minus c is equal to 3 over a. 3 over 1 is equal to 3. From these two, we can find b and c. Let's add. We have 2b equals 4 and b is equal to 2. And if b is equal to 2, c is equal to negative 1. Satisfying this equations, we have found all our unknown. Let's write our factors now. Our quadratic becomes our x to the power 4 minus 3x minus 2 becomes x squared plus ax, which is 1x, plus b, which is 2, times x squared minus ax, which is minus x and minus c, sorry, plus c, but c is negative 1. So this is minus 1. That's very nice, since we know how to solve the quadratics. From the quadratic formula, x is equal to negative 1 plus minus 1 squared minus 4 times 1 times 2, which is negative 7. And that is also equal to root 7 times I, all divided by 2. And the other part, we have x is equal to negative negative 1 becomes 1 plus minus. Negative 1 squared is 1 minus 4 times 1 times negative 1 becomes positive 4 plus 1 becomes 5. So these are real roots. These two are real roots. One of them is the golden ratio, 1 plus root 5 divided by 2. And these two are our complex roots. Thank you for watching and see you in the next videos.